Right. Now let's see the coagulation in lyophilic salts. Lyophobic salts, I have discussed how to coagulate a lyophobic salt. For lyophilic salt, how to coagulate? So you know which are relatively more stable between lyophilic and lyophobic? Yes, lyophilic salts are more stable. Why? Here not only charges and the colloidal particles, there is another process called solvation. It also responsible for the stabilization of a colloid. So a lyophilic salt is stabilized in two ways. One, by adsorbing charges from the electrolyte. Second one, by the solvation process. So if you remove these two charges, charged layer and it is solvated layer, there are two layers. That means a lyophilic colloidal, this is lyophilic colloidal particle, it is surrounded by charges and it is surrounded by some solvent molecules also. This is the layer formed by the solvent molecules. Solvent means dispersion medium. So in order to coagulate a lyophilic salt, these two, first we have to break this solvent layer first. After that we have to neutralize the charges. Whereas in lyophobic, what happened there? This is lyophobic, this is lyophilic salt. In lyophobic salt, only there are charges around the colloidal particles. If you neutralize these charges, then automatically it will be coagulated. So only addition of salt is sufficient to coagulate a lyophobic. But to coagulate a lyophilic, there are two factors that stabilize the colloidal solution. What are those two factors? Charges in the fixed layer of colloidal solution and solvent, a layer of solvent molecules. So if we break this one and if we neutralize the charges, then only it is coagulated. So if a lyophilic salt is coagulated by more amount of salt and in the presence of a co-solvent. Here co-solvent interacts with the solvent layer, that means dispersion medium. So if we add for hydrophilic salts, if you add either acetone or ether, what happens? This acetone or ether simply breaks the layer of solvent molecules by hydrogen bonding. So as a result, what happens? The layer of solvent is first broken. Now the addition of electrolyte causes neutralization of the charges, which ultimately leads to the coagulation of a positive colloid. Okay, so for the coagulation of a positive colloid, there are two factors. What are they? A lyophilic salt is coagulated by a lyophilic salt is stabilized by two factors. A lyophilic salt is stabilized by two factors. First one, solvation. Second factor is charges in the fixed layer. In the fixed layer of colloidal particles. These two factors are responsible for the more stability of a lyophilic salt. But you know, in a lyophobic salt, only charges in the fixed layer of colloids. That's why simply by the addition of salt, it gets coagulated. But by the addition of salt only, a lyophilic is not coagulated. Why? Salt can neutralize charges only. But what about solvation? The layer of solvent molecules cannot be removed by the salt. That's why for the solvation effect, for hydrophilic salts means where the dispersion medium is water. For hydrophilic salts, acetone or ether is added to remove hydration layer. So first hydration layer is broken by the addition of a co-solvent. So here a stone or either added na, that acts as co-solvent. That acts as co-solvent. This co-solvent interacts with the solvent layer, that means hydration layer, to break it. So simply the layer of solvent is broken by the addition of this solvent. Second thing is salt is added. Charges are neutralized by charges in the fixed layer. Are neutralized by electrolytes. So in that way, a lyophilic salt is coagulated. So which can be easily coagulated, either lyophilic or lyophobic? Yes, lyophobic is easily coagulated. Whereas it is difficult to coagulate a lyophilic salt. Why? A lyophilic salt is prevented from the coagulation by two factors. One is solvation factor, other one is charges in the fixed layer of colloidal particles. In the case of lyophobic salts, only there is no solvation effect. There is only charges in the fixed layer of colloidal particles. Those charges are only responsible for the stability of lyophobic. For a lyophilic, these two factors are responsible for the stability of the colloid. So that's why a co-solvent is needed to break the layer of solvent, and a salt is added to neutralize the charges in the fixed layer. Okay, so this is about coagulation of a lyophilic salt.